Okay, this is Chaos with Occupy Wisconsin. We're up here at the top of State Street where Tami Miller is feeding the State Street family. 15 weeks pregnant. No time left in the shelter, so, you know, it's getting below freezing here at night, and she is now stuck out on the street.
Well, I've been in the shelter on and off for 2 years, and all of a sudden, like a couple days ago, they told me I can't be here no more because I have no more days.
Like, okay,
so I am 15 weeks pregnant, and I told them that, and they didn't give a crap. So they told me I had to leave, or they'll call the police.
I did get one day in a hotel, but that was just
you
only
had,
for one day.
Just slippers on, and
yeah.
Somebody, Tami Miller, gave her her
and
boots.
I got 4 years, and yeah.
Did you have a job up here?
Yeah, I did have a job on State Street, KFC and Taco Bell.
Oh, and they both closed down. How's your luck finding another job?
Hard, very hard, because I'm homeless, and they look at me like I'm homeless.
It's hard.
So it's not like you're not trying.
No, it's not that. I love to work. I want to work, and yeah, it's kind of hard to find a job when nobody won't give me one.
It's pretty hard to find housing when you have no income.
Oh, we got income. It's just nobody won't give me give us apartment. They said we don't triple the rent or whatever they're trying to say. So, I mean, we got money and everything, and we get it paid every month. It's just hard to find an apartment, a decent
when
apartment, without bed bugs.
In that spring across the sea, the world was changed forever by some normal folks.
And this is Tami Miller.
Well, about a year ago, we started bringing things down to State Street, and as we got to know people who are homeless, realize there are so many
needs. We don't have to be a big,
huge
agency
to make a difference. We can do, you know, I'm a single mom, live in a little apartment, I drive a car that usually works. You know, we bring survival gear, we find people that camp out in the woods, we find people who live in their cars, we find people who sleep under bridges.
We estimate there's
about 400 people living outside, unsheltered, in Madison. And we try to find them, and we try to help them, and show them that we care about them.
How did you get started in this? I mean, you didn't just all of a sudden one day just started showing up with food, so...
I did, actually.
Did you?
Yeah. Well, I saw a woman, actually. I was volunteering at St. Mary's in the ER, and a woman came in who was having a psychotic episode, and she was homeless, and she was about my mom's age, and she was just screaming and crying, and she looked right at me. I went in to sit with her and calm her down, and she looked right at me, and she said, "Help me. Tell God to help me. I can't take this anymore."
And it just
broke my heart. Is it possible in our society, with all the money we have and all the resources we have, for someone who is so in need of help to be homeless and to have nothing and no one to help them until they get to the point where they have to be in an emergency room? You're saving lives by doing this. You're saving lives when you bring a sleeping bag and a tent and warmth to people who are sleeping outside in the wintertime in Wisconsin.
Just giving people hugs and talking to them and caring about them is just the biggest thing, because, you know, Mother Teresa used to say the greatest poverty is the poverty of
being loved.
And that's part of what we try to do, is show people we love them and we care about them. And you can do that too. You don't have to have any money to do that. So just don't be afraid of people who are homeless. They're just like everybody else. They're just like you and me. And they need to be shown that they're cared about too, just like anyone else.
It's greed that keeps the working class just barely hanging on.